Masters Hockey on MSG Networks is presented by Mount Sinai SAS. Nassau in Oceanside, we find a way. It's one of the biggest games of the season as the Islanders host their crosstown rivals, the Rangers, here at UBS Arena for the very first time. Rivalry night tonight on MSG Networks. Hello, everyone. Welcome inside UBS Arena at Belmont Park. I'm Shannon Hogan. Puck drop between the Islanders and the Rangers coming to you in moments right here on MSG Plus 2. A lot has unfolded in the last couple of days and even the last hour. Let's catch you up on what's going on with the Islanders and their roster. It has been wild. The latest to test positive for COVID-19 is Zdeno Chara. That was on Monday, so he's added to the Islanders' COVID protocol list. Now 7 players long. Also, Brock Nelson out 2 to 4 weeks with a lower body injury, and we just found out moments ago when the players took the ice for warm-ups that also Noah Dobson is considered day-to-day with a lower body injury. It has gotten so crazy, I needed a cheat sheet. That's right, we need the lines. Thank God I don't have to call the game. That is the pleasure of Brendan Burke and Butch Goring. Let's welcome them in now for more.
Yeah, we're still studying numbers, getting ready for this one as Islanders and Rangers play. But unfortunately, again, like the last couple of games, this game will be played under a cloud of COVID. 7 players on the COVID list, throw in 3 injuries on top of that. The Islanders are missing 5 of their 6 defensemen. It's going to be a tough test tonight. Would have been with a healthy roster.
You know what? Barry Trotz is going to have to wave his magic wand. I'd also throw the puck in the corner if I was playing, but it'd be in Clark Gillies' corner. But there's no doubt the guys have got to make sure they're not outworked in any way, shape, or form, and they've got to play a really smart game. Keep the puck ahead of you, chip and chase, no blue line turnovers, just make it a simple, simple game.
For our Taco Bell take tonight, we're going to go back in time, way back to last Monday, 9 days ago, for the game against the Tampa Bay Lightning. This is what the lineup looked like for the Islanders. They were completely healthy, except for the fact that Noah Dobson with actually a healthy scratch in this game. Tonight, he'll miss it because of a lower body injury. Fast forward to tonight, Butch. This is what the lineup looks like. These are the newcomers that come in. We will see Thomas Hickey make his season debut. Here tonight, we'll see Paul Ledoux make his Islanders debut, and we will see Otto Koivula make his season debut as well.
And 9 of those players started in the American Hockey League, and you know what? There's such a thing, Brendan, as having an even playing field. I mean, this is the National Hockey League, and clearly tonight, it's not. I mean, when you're playing with 9 minor leaguers, that's half your hockey team. For me, that's a tremendous challenge. The other thing is, the fans here, they deserve to see the New York Islanders. They're not really seeing them tonight. And I think, in fairness to the fans, when you pay $200 for a ticket, I think that, you got to reevaluate what's going on.
Well, you might see something special for your $200 here tonight if the Islanders can put out a win against the New York Rangers. They are off to a great start. Top of the Metropolitan Division, or near the top of the Metropolitan Division, a guy like Chris Kreider, near the top of the goal scoring list, and Adam Fox having a heck of a follow-up to his Norris Trophy campaign.
Well, how many years have you heard Chris Kreider, they should move him? Well, I think all the Ranger fans are pretty happy that he's still a New York Ranger. And this is a guy that's really learned his trade. He's always been a big, strong skater with a good shot. But now he understands how to go to the net, how to find the holes, when to stay in front of the net, that net front presence, when just to slide off here and there. He's got such an active stick. He's become one of the best net front presence hockey players in the entire National Hockey League. And this guy here, Adam Fox, well, listen, he's a Norris Trophy winner from last year. He has all kinds of offensive skills. He's learning how to be a better defenseman, Brendan, and I think that's important for him to have a little bit more success. But make no mistake about it, he's got tremendous hockey sense and tremendous skill.
And it's just his 3rd season in the National Hockey League. In goal tonight for the Islanders, Semyon Varlamov still looking for his first win as we take a look at the Audi starting goaltenders. Visit your Tri-State Audi dealer today and get behind the wheel of the Audi model you've always wanted. 0-3 start for Varlamov, who missed the first 6 games because of injury. Up against Igor Shesterkin, he has been outstanding. One of the reasons the Rangers' record is what it is because of Igor Shesterkin, who is looking for his 10th win of the season already tonight. First of 4 meetings this year between the Islanders and Rangers, with the next one coming up on Sunday. But this, the first ever Islanders-Rangers matchup here at UBS Arena. Closing in on Puck Drop. On your shoulders, that's just how you gotta play. When you really want success, you gotta do it for the win. You gotta do it for the win. Watch me do it for the win. Get into it, get it in. Never give up for the win. Do it big for the win. Going hard for the win. Play your part for the win. You can do it for the win. Do it for the win. Watch me do it for the win. Get into it, get it in. Never give up for the win. For the win. The New York Islanders Tri-State matchup is brought to you by BMW. Happy Thanksgiving Eve, Islanders and Rangers, for the first time ever here at UBS Arena. Islanders looking to snap a six-game skid, and Barry Trotz is trying to figure out how he is going to configure his roster for tonight. Butch, it's a tough task to look down and try and figure out how you're going to generate some more offense. The Islanders have only scored six total goals in their last six games, and they're missing a lot of their parts trying to pick up some more offense.
I remember being in a similar situation, Brendan, in the American Hockey League, and you're juggling people around and you're trying to change the strategy a little bit to try and figure out how do you win a hockey game, and it's not easy. They can find a way to win tonight, Brendan. It might be his best coaching job ever. I mean, because he's missing a lot of talent out there, and this is a very good Ranger team. So see if the Islanders can get off to a good start. That'll be really important.
So an A on the jersey of J.G. Pageau. There's one on Cal Clutterbuck's jersey as well. Of course, the Islanders missing their captain, Anders Lee. They're missing one of their alternates in Josh Bailey. Islanders get the puck in offensively right away and start hacking away at it at the side of the net. Mika Zibanejad tried to clear and wound up a turnover. Matt Martin's shot was blocked. Cizikas behind the net gets away from Trouba. Angles one back towards Mayfield. That one fluttering to the net, blocked down by Trouba, and he will escape. Scott Mayfield wearing an A on his sweater. He is the last man standing on the Islander blue line. If you talk about the top six defensemen for the Islanders they started the season with, the other five are all out either by injury, Ryan Pulock and Noah Dobson, or with COVID protocol in terms of Chara, Pellick, and Andy Green.
Yeah, I mean, the injuries are one thing, but then when you lose all your defensemen, that just makes everybody's task a whole lot tougher.
Pageau with it in his own slot, lost it. Mayfield right there to clean it up. His pass off Palmieri's stick for the wrong side of center, though, and it is an icing against the Islanders.
Yeah, pretty close, but a good start for the Islanders. And Barry Trotz goes with the Cizikas line for obvious reasons, and they don't disappoint. They win the faceoff. They get in there, and they hack and whack, and they create opportunities, a couple of point shots. So the Islanders are on their toes, and that's just really the way they got to play it, Brendan, is they've got to get the puck in deep and force the Rangers to come 200 feet each and every time.
Rangers have won five of their last six games, point in eight of their last 10. That'll be out of the reach of Beauvillier, and another icing as well there, coming off a dramatic victory over the Buffalo Sabres on Sunday. Ryan Lindgren scoring with less than a second remaining to give them a 5-4 regulation win.
When you're hot, Brendan, and the Rangers do no wrong over the last little while, and they've played good hockey. And so, you know, when you're playing a team that really you don't want to play them when everything is going right for them, but then it becomes a little bit better challenge, that's all.
Beauvillier stopped right at the blue line, trying to escape the pass on for Lafreniere, trying to dangle between his legs, came right to Filippino, and a penalty upcoming here against the Islanders as Hedl's shot went across the open net. It's a slash, and the Islanders shorthanded.
And the Islanders had a chance to get it out right at the blue line, and they just didn't get it out. And then the Rangers quick transition. And now Palmieri will be in the penalty box. And good opportunity. There's a couple of slashes by Palmieri, and could have been Hickey too. And there were several guys that were hacking and whacking. But certainly Pageau is right in there, number 44. And it's an easy call for the refs. And the Islanders, this is an important kill for them.
Adam Fox gets it back one, times it, and Varlamov was right there to stop it. But already a shot on goal just 7 seconds into the power play for the Rangers.
As Zibanejad in that slot area, he was looking to deflect it. He didn't. And Varlamov had an easy look. A Ranger power play, very, very effective. Kreider's usually hanging around the front of the net, and he's become a very good net front presence.
Rangers 11-4-52 on the season. That's just a shade over 21% success rate. 1-for-1 against Buffalo their last time out, as Fox plays it to Panarin. Pumps a pass, then throws it to the middle for Zibanejad. Tap wide. Strom sends it out for Fox. Fox has some room. Strom and back to Fox. Over for Panarin. Artemi Panarin. Whips one to the net. It got through. Varlamov to save. Everybody clamps down around the net. Islanders get it up but not out. Fox with the keep in. And the skates of Panarin. Zibanejad. Goal line. Tried to go across. Broken up by Hickey, and a diving play by Cizikas.
Tyrese will get it out to center.
A great second effort, but a lot of different looks from the Rangers. Shots from the slot, shots from the point, looking for deflections. Great ability to get that puck to the net, Brendan.
Exactly halfway through the power play, minute left to go. Islanders coming up shorthanded, 2-on-1. Parisi with Pageau, the shot blocked by Fox. 2.5 minutes gone by here in the opening period. No score, Islanders and Rangers as Panarin sets up shop on the half wall. 45 left on the power play. Zibanejad back to Panarin. Touchdown high, Truba. Looks it over for Strome. Widens the slap pass through, looking for Kreider. Now Panarin, 35 on the power play. Panarin to the net, blocked by Ledoux, and he clears.
He tried to look Mayfield out. Strome was on the far side. That's Panarin looking for a cross-ice pass. Islanders do a nice job of getting in the passing lanes.
Hickey and Mayfield back out to try and finish off this kill. 15 seconds left. It's cleared down by Hickey. That's the same Thomas Hickey, his first NHL game since March of last year. He's only played 5 of the last few seasons. Seems to have a different number every time he does. He's wearing 42 this year. And a collision between Hickey and Lundqvist down in the corner. Out of the box comes Palmieri. Islanders have killed that off. Beauvillier picks his head up, feeds Palmieri. Palmieri waiting for Beauvillier to get there. Broken up by Capocacco, then Palmieri delivers a hit that sends Lafreniere down to the ice.
Expect the Islanders to be very, very physical, Brendan, and in an effort to slow the Rangers down, get them to get their heads up.
Nemeth nearly stripped by Ponick. Comes free to Parisi. Zach Parisi with an off-angled shot that pinballed out in front. Oh. He fights through it, draws a penalty, does Parisi. And the Islanders, a successful kill. And they'll head to the power play.
I thought it was Miller with the high stick, but it might have been Goudreau behind the net.
There's 21, minor penalty, high stick.
Goudreau behind the net, got his stick up in the face of Parisi. Like the play from the corner, Brendan. Get it to the front of the net. You never know what pinball effect it might happen. There was the penalty in behind the net. So the Islanders, they were working on their power play yesterday, Brendan. I went to practice, watched them. They worked about 15, 20 minutes. So let's see if they can be a little bit fortunate and execute.
They were 0-for-3 on Sunday. They're just 5-for-41 on the season. 12.2%, 30th out of the 32 teams in the NHL. Just 1-for-21 in the month of November. Barzal hustles to steal a puck away before the Rangers could clear it. Aho gives it back to Matt Barzal. Barzal, Aho, Beauvillier, Pageau, and Ponick as this one is lifted over the glass.
Well, shoot first mentality, not a bad thing, as that was deflected. One of the things they worked on yesterday, Brendan, was puck retrieval. Now, if you don't have the puck, you got to be hungry to get it back. And that was a good effort by the three forwards for the Islanders in getting that puck after losing the faceoff.
Pageau tossed out of the draw, so Barzal will take it. Rangers PK is 25th in the league. They've given up a power play goal in 4 of the last 5 games. Aho to Beauvillier. Return feed to Sebastian Aho. Now Barzal sets up. Aho, the one-timer blocked by Rooney and then cleared by Strome.
It's amazing how the defensive team lines up in the middle of the ice and you manage to hit him. You almost think, Brendan, why would you move to the side a little more, right?
This Islanders power play brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers. Pageau over the line. Leaves it at the top for Aho. Moves to the middle. Aho to Barzal. Pageau in front. Ponick in the slot. Beauvillier in the near circle. Beauvillier slap pass right through the skates of Ponick, collected by Barzal.
A good try there.
Minute 3 to go on the power play for the Isles. Barzal snuck a pass all the way over, but it was in the skates of Beauvillier. Cleared out off the linesman, and it comes right to Aho. Barzal was tracked down. Over the boards comes Otto Koivula. A little power play time here as this one is cleared the length of the ice.
Koivula's been up for a number of times over a couple of years, so he's not new to the Islanders and certainly shouldn't be nervous about playing in tonight's game, although it's a Ranger Islander game.
Didn't play an NHL game last season, Otto Koivula. And this one is held in by Oliver Wahlstrom. Wahlstrom wanted Salo on the wrong side of his body. Parisi hustling to it. Salo pinned against the boards. Met by Strome. Koivula kept it moving. Out high for Palmieri. One timer. Wahlstrom put it down. gives it back to Palmieri, tees one up, and the save made by Shesterkin. He does not allow a rebound.
Yeah, good job covering up that puck. It tried to sneak through the five hole. Wallstrom wanted the one-timer, and a puck just kind of handcuffed him a little bit. Great play by Parisi to get it out, and there's the play by Wallstrom. Couldn't let it go. Smart decision. And then Aho with that let that shot go was good idea. Look at all the guys in front. You wonder how does it ever get through sometimes? And how does the goalie see it?
Just 10 seconds left on this Islander power play. There's been some special teams, Butch, but some energy to this hockey game right off the bat.
Yeah, both teams are ready to go. For the Rangers, they would like nothing better than to certainly beat the Islanders in their home park. We'll do.
Hickey with a shot blocked by Rudy, comes right back to him, shoveled behind the net. Pajot dealing with Trouba. Out of the box comes Barclay Goudreau. Trouba went to hit him with a pass.
That should be icing.
And it will be. Icing called here as we're back to 5-on-5, and the Islanders will have an opportunity to pick their five. And Casey Cizikas and company will get the shoulder tap from Barry Trotz.
And Barry Trotz is forced to put his pairs together and live with what he's got. Ledoux and Hickey are out there together.
Paul Ledoux wearing 34, 69 games of NHL experience, but none before tonight since December 6th, 2019. Played for the LA Kings a bit. It's been last year in the American Hockey League with the Hershey Bears. He's wearing 34 for the Islanders, making his season debut. And here he is with the puck with a shot that went to the net but was stopped by Keandre Miller. Cizikas punches it back out for Ledoux, drags and shoots. That one hit Clutterbuck right in front of the goal.
That had a chance to go in too, Brendan, as Shesterkin was down low. That was a high shot. So Ledoux not scared to shoot the puck.
The dump in off the stick of Clutterbuck. Shesterkin out the play, and Matt Martin, first one on it, puts it back to the near side. Clutterbuck lining up his man. That was Lafreniere. Nemeth will try the other way. Gauthier, long pass into the skates of Lafreniere. He'll shoot it in. Almost 7 minutes gone by here in the opening period of Islanders Rangers for the first time at UBS Arena at Belmont Park. Just the third ever game played in this building. Islanders still looking for their first win in their new home. Gauthier turns back, angles one off the net, out to the line. Kept by Nemeth. Shot over. Overskated initially by Lafreniere. To the corner for Strom. Needle. Met there by Grant Hutton. Then Lafreniere. Nowhere to go with it. Pressured up against the glass by Otto Koivula. And Koivula will take it. He couldn't get away. Comes free. Andreon trying to get there along with Lundqvist. And it rolls back. Hutton has it. Islanders have some time. The Rangers in a change. Aho, stretch pass. Wallstrom had a roll off a stick. Wallstrom puts Lindgren into the end wall. Follow-up hit by Ponick. That was on Dryden Hunt. And Salo finds Matt Barzal, who twists and turns, looking for a way away from Ryan Strom. Robin Salo. He's played 21 minutes or more in each of his first two NHL games, turned it over inside the zone, and now Hunt up with it for the Rangers.
You can see he's very confident in wanting to carry the puck. He's got to learn when to let it go.
This one skips through Fox. Doesn't have enough juice for an icing. Barzal will put the pressure on Lindgren. He throws a hard hit, and he set up Parisi, but it's squeezed by Shesterkin. Barzal with the forecheck, the hit on Lindgren, and it turns into a scoring chance for Zach Parisi. Barzal got the better of Lindgren on that one. You can win a pair of Islanders tickets to the Islanders New Jersey Devils game on December 11th and a team signed Islanders hat in the WBAB Islanders Player to Watch sweepstakes. Listen to Roger and JP on WBAB 102.3 tomorrow morning at 8:50 a.m. and call in for your chance to win. Remember, the WBAB Islanders Player to Watch is Matt Barzal, who seems to shine when the Rangers are on the ice with him. 25 points in 20 career games for Barzal against the Rangers.
I guess he likes the rivalry. Brendan gets all excited about it. And why wouldn't you? It's always fun to play the New York Rangers.
He's not one to shy away from the spotlight, that's for sure.
No, and that's a chance to shine in the Big Apple.
Islanders will play the Rangers again on Sunday, each team having one game in between. As Ponick, Barzal from a tough angle. He Took a hit there from Trouba. Islanders will play Pittsburgh here on Friday night. The Rangers will play Friday afternoon, a 1 o'clock game in Boston against the Bruins. Fox was taken care of by Parisi, but lots of room here for Rooney to step in and shoot. That was blocked by Hickey and cleared out.
Good play by Kovila, as he saw that Parisi was down low and helped him out.
Lots of Let's Go Islanders and Let's Go Rangers here, with no doubt a split building to some extent. There's probably some split car rides on the way to and from this game as well.
Interesting enough, there's a husband and wife who wear different jerseys for this game, and that makes for a lot of fun.
Two will play tonight and Sunday, then they won't play again until April. Enjoy it while you can. Palmieri kicks this one ahead. Beauvillier was tripped up by an errant stick in the neutral zone, coming after him, but he's beaten to the puck by Nemeth.
That was Palmieri's.
Nils Lundqvist took a hit from Pajot. They got the crowd excited as Capo Caco carries in, shovels off for Lafreniere. His shot blocked by Mayfield. Robin Salo, far side. Palmieri coming to it. Nils Lundqvist was there as well, and Beauvillier twisting and turning. Lost to handle, and it's taken back by Hedl and the Rangers.
Yeah, you got to make sure you get those out just inside your blue line. Everybody's standing.
Halfway through the first, it's kicked away by Varlamov. Save number 5 in the game for Varlamov as Cizikas comes flying across the line. Clutterbuck stepping, shooting, shouldered away by Shesterkin.
A nice save there. Great play by Cizikas to get it over to Clutter and then drive to center. Created a little time and space for him.
Aho, he can skate, shovels it on for Clutterbuck down the wall. Clutterbuck steps around Miller, goes after Trouba. Puck tied up there, comes free for Barzal. Saucered out for Hutton. Hutton looks it over to Aho, to the net, it was tipped and went wide. Matt Martin got a stick on that shot. Hutton, good keep it. Aho clutches and throws it on goal, though. Traffic, no problem for Igor Shesterkin. Good pace to this hockey game. We played 11 minutes of it here at UBS Arena. No score, Isles and Rangers. So far tonight, no score. 9 minutes to go in the opening period. Some chances, though, for the Isles. Butch, to open the scoring.
Clutterbuck with a good outside chance. You can see he's off on the angle, and Shesterkin's able to square up, make a nice save. But I like the positioning of Matt Martin in front of the net there. A little deflection, and that had Shesterkin beaten. Good play by Hutton over to Aho to Matt Martin, who got a stick on it. But they've had some offensive opportunities, and as you mentioned, Brendan, it's been a good pace, and the Islanders are prepared to work tonight. No question there.
Early shots, 5 for the Rangers, 4 for the Islanders. None have gone in as Varlamov steps out to set up Paul Ledoux. Wrapped into the skates of Palmieri. Over for Thomas Hickey. Beauvillier angles it in.
That's what I'm talking about, the simple play. That's a little quick little pass, and then chip the puck in and go ahead and forecheck.
Palmieri to the boards. His pass to Beauvillier was knocked aside. Hickey with a nice keep in there, but it only works for a moment. Now Ledoux and Panarin hustling after this one. Panarin beats out the icing, curls and looks for a pass. Ledoux trying to wrap up Artemi Panarin. Hickey gets rid of it and then takes a big hit from Ryan Reeves. Beauvillier couldn't get it past Fox at the line. Now Strome for Fox, and it's blocked by Palmieri, who dropped down on a knee. Beauvillier and Strome, and the stick came up from Strome to Beauvillier, and the Islanders will go back on the power play.
Yeah, he tried to knock the puck out of midair and got it up, but didn't let the puck drop down far enough. That's just a reflex by Ryan Strome.
Strome is saying that he didn't get him, and so is Ryan Reeves. And it's the puck.
Well, the puck got him.
So they got together, the officials did. It's a high stick in terms of hitting the puck high, but the puck was actually what hit Anthony Beauvillier, not the stick.
But the stick hit him on the shoulder. That's still a high stick. You watch that replay, that's still a high stick. No matter how you cut that one. Let the Rangers catch a break.
See Gerard Gallant, their new head coach, after the Islanders beat the Rangers 6 out of 8 meetings last year and handed them a couple of decisive losses with their season on the line late in the year. And those are some of the things that led to the undoing for their general manager, Jeff Gorton, and their head coach, David Quinn, who have both since been replaced.
And the ending of the season, basically, for the Rangers, too.
So 5-on-5 still as that penalty against Ryan Strom has been rescinded. And it's played down for Park Lake Goodrow, one of the big offseason acquisitions. Although the larger physically offseason acquisition, Ryan Reeves, is out there as well, wearing 75 for the Rangers.
Yeah, you don't want to get him a free run at you.
Aho with a little razzle dazzle and then puts it through center. Otto Koivula is pass blocked by Rooney, picked up by Andreoff. Congestion in the slot. The puck comes to the corner. The big body of Otto Koivula working it away from Lindgren. Mayfield hands it back to Koivula. In the give and go exchange, Mayfield's shot rockets off the glass. Steered up the boards. Mayfield hustling, gets there along the wall. Misfired on the shot. Reeves forces it out and back in Islander territory.
Yeah, you know, fans who are watching this game are going to say, well, how does he miss the net? Well, he's got to get it past the onrushing checker. So you take what's given to you, and sometimes you just can't get it on the net.
Mayfield to center for Richard Punnett. Parisi trying to go in. Barzell on it. Up against the rookie Nils Lundqvist. His pass directed by Kako out to center. This Rangers roster is very much intact from last season with a couple of additions, as this is icing against the Islanders. Tonight, the first 10,000 fans that entered UBS Arena received a custom t-shirt designed by an Islanders fan for Islanders fans. At UBS Arena, there will be giveaways like this all season long. Purchase single game tickets now when you visit NewYorkIslanders.com/ticks. 6:40 left here in the first period. Brendan Burke and Butch Goring from UBS Arena at Belmont Park. Barzell to take the faceoff against Mika Zibanejad.
And he wins it.
Trouba keeps it in with his skates, and then Barzell's pass was not on target. Kreider to the net. Zibanejad on the follow-up, and Varlamov got them both with the heel of his glove. Barzell through center, can't dance around Trouba.
Well, he had him though, Brendan. He had him going the wrong way. If he gets you past the skate, he's going in all alone. And that Trouba moving in the wrong direction.
Zibanejad to Kako. Shot it in. Hickey stopped it quickly up ice for Matt Barzell with the Rangers D and a change. Barzell to the outside, hangs onto it, threw it right across the crease. Nobody home for the Isles.
He's looking for a clutterbuck in that area.
Heedle off the boards. In stride for Lundqvist. Lafreniere, number one overall pick from a few years ago, went right through the crease. Cizikas on the other side, gets it in around Nemeth.
Yeah, that was Gauthier. They drove right to the net, Brendan. Just couldn't quite handle that Lafreniere pass. Both teams going hard to the net.
Here is Gauthier trying to go wide on Hutton. Gauthier. Fox slaps it over for Lindgren. Lindgren towards the goal. Lafreniere angled it away. Beauvillier and Lafreniere tangled up. Aho for Palmieri. Slipped it on through. 2-on-1. Beauvillier has Cizikas. Beauvillier blocked down by Fox as he tried to feed the pass over.
Good play by Fox. Kept his stick down and was looking for the pass.
A couple of Rangers collide. Fox and Lindgren, both their defensemen, went down together. And then down goes Palmieri with a stick in his skates. Pageau finds the loose puck. Pageau, Beauvillier with a shot. Palmieri draws a penalty, yeah, as he was looking for the rebound. Fox will go for hooking. The Islanders will go on the power play.
Oh, good hustle again by the Islanders in the offensive zone. Forechecking extremely well.
Kyle Palmieri looking for a rebound. Got a stick right in the hands from Adam Fox.
A physical game, especially for the Islanders. Palmieri and then Barzell. Everybody's in the action. Beauvillier and then finally Pageau. So Rangers have found themselves in a hockey game. If they expected a walkover, it hasn't happened. The Islanders are ready to play, and being physical means you're skating, Brendan. You can't hit anybody if you're not skating.
Puck possession time, the Islanders have the early edge. They also have the edge in hits, 9-5. Islanders on the power play for the second time here in the first period. Palmieri tapped in front from Parisi to Pageau, but misfired.
That was a play they worked on yesterday quite a bit.
This is cleared down as Varlamov stops it. This Islanders power play is brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers.
That's one. The first time you run that, Brendan, you have to score. I mean, you can't fan on the shot. And now the Rangers will be kind of ready for it.
Islanders can't get it into the zone. Islanders managed just one shot on goal during their first power play opportunity. Matt Martin has gone to the locker room for the New York Islanders, at least for the moment. Wahlstrom's pass was redirected by Kreider out to center. And Wahlstrom hustling back here. The only defenseman on the ice is Robin Salo. Islanders have given up an uncharacteristic three shorthanded goals.
That was almost too many men in the
It's a giveaway, and it's a chance for Trouba, and it's a penalty against the Islanders, and that'll be the end of the power play.
That's just unbelievable how often the Islanders make those mistakes. I mean, it's just laziness in their own zone. I mean, you've got to be
better. Islanders 13, minor penalty, hook.
Recognize the situation. Trouba goes in, and there's the hook. I mean, that's a good play by Barzal. I mean, Trouba's going in all alone, although I like the percentages for the goalie when you're talking about a defenseman who's not necessarily an offensive-minded guy, although he does have a good shot. But that's just unacceptable stuff that the players, I mean, that's decision-making. Barry Trotz talked about that. So the decisions that these guys have been making are, you know, that's part of the problem.
So there's a Norris Trophy winner in one penalty box and a Calder Trophy winner in the other. Fox and Barzal locked away. Fox will be out in 48. Barzal will sit for longer. So 4-on-4 here. 3.5 to go in the first. DeAndre Miller had himself a fine rookie season last year for the Rangers. Passes on to Strome and then Panarin. Trouba has to collect it. Down to the goal line, Strome wanted to return it. Blocked down by Aho. Beauvillier lost it, and a couple of Rangers were in tight. Could do nothing with it, and an errant pass from Strome will clear the zone. 12 seconds left in the Fox penalty, and then it'll be a Ranger power play. As Mika Zibanejad over the line with Kreider. Beauvillier on the steal. Rangers D is slow getting on the ice on that change. They turned on the Jets though when they saw Beauvillier coming towards them.
Yeah, luckily they didn't have too many men on the ice there. And a lot of times people are jumping and you get caught in a bad situation.
Here's a steal by Cizikas. Shorthanded. Cizikas ducks the shoulder on Panarin and Shesterkin makes the stop.
That's a really good move by Cizikas. Knowing you have a forward, challenge him.
Kreider feeds it down for Zibanejad. 40 seconds left on this abbreviated Ranger power play. Scrum in the corner. Three of the four Islanders were in deep there. It rolls all the way out to Fox. Cizikas, no doubt with a little gas left in the tank. Defensively, tracking after Adam Fox. Fox to the net, that one knocked down on its way. Then centered for Zibanejad, and it's blocked in front by Hickey. Play to the end wall. Kreider came away with it. Worked out for Fox, and the slap pass altered by Cizikas up into the netting. Just 12 seconds left on the Islander kill.
Good job for the Islanders to get into the shooting lanes, the passing lanes, and Zeker coming out hard on Fox is able to scoop the puck away. And I love this move. Just drop the shoulder, protect the puck. You've got a forward in there, and Cizikas is able to drive it to the net. And watch the lean in, put the puck out in front of you, and force Shesterkin to make a nice save. But a good strong play to the net by Cizikas. Again, recognizing it was Panarin who was back there.
So still 12 seconds to kill for the Islanders. Pageau will not take it against Hedl. He's tossed out, so Lafreniere will stand in.
Lafreniere, a center in junior hockey. Doesn't work in the pros, though.
This one shot down the ice by Paul Ledoux. Shesterkin pops out to play it to Filip Hedl. Barzal out in 2 seconds and one as Gauthier comes in wide, gets it to the front, poked over the top of the net as Lafreniere goes down in the Islanders' crease. Meanwhile, Parisi gave it away to Nemeth. Nemeth backhands it wide. Lafreniere now back on his skates, picks up the puck. Left into the corner now for Hedl. Hedl pressured by Pageau. And the pass deflects out to center. Islanders will be able to get their lineup figured out, although still no Matt Martin on the Islander bench.
Islanders have been making pretty smart changes, keeping themselves fresh. Cizikas line looking to get out there.
Just as I say that, Matt Martin has returned to the Islander bench and is trying to find his spot. His spot, though, is on the ice right now. Andy Andreoff taking a shift with Cizikas and Clutterbuck.
Yeah, not good timing for Matt. Yeah. Sorry, Matt, he's going to miss your shift.
Final minute of the period. Cizikas ties up. Clutterbuck gets involved with Barclay Goodrow. Toss to the front, nobody home, and it's Fox. Cizikas and Lindgren are wrapped up behind the play. Meanwhile, Goodrow for Ryan Reeves trying to hit a trailing Rooney, deflected away from him. Then Aho dumped Rooney down to the ice. Fox keeps it alive. Adam Fox wanted to go to the net. Andreoff with the block. Fox picks it up, centers for Reeves, and that one deflected out of play.
Andreoff's got to go right at Fox. As soon as he makes the play, take him out. Yeah, he's a good offensive player. You let him back into the game right there. Such a little thing, Brendan, the guys just at times they forget about that. Once a guy makes a play, just step in front of him or don't turn away. Reeves been, I guess, really a good guy in the room, and obviously he knows his role on the ice. Of course, Gallant had him in Vegas, too.
He did. I was about to point out, you know his hometown, right?
Sure, Winnipeg.
He's a Winnipegger.
Yep. Well, Winnipeg has finesse, and they have toughness.
His dad, Willard Reeves,
yes,
played in the Canadian Football League for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
A really good player, too, Brendan, a really good player.
A little bit in the NFL, but longer career in the CFL.
Yeah, he was a halfback or a fullback. I'm not sure the terminology back in the, I believe it was the 60s.
Pajot will take the faceoff. He'd won 6 of 7 before that one. And somebody will get a win for that.
Yeah.
Not really sure who.
Islanders had possession, so possibly them.
Carey back in here, 19 seconds to go in the period. Richard Ponick trying to get around Miller. Throws the hit on Trouba. Palmieri a little late to get there. Panarin snaps a pass over for Miller. 10 seconds to go in the period. Hunt tips this in around Salo. Varlamov out to play it. Salo with 5. Looks up. Alley-oop through center ice. Palmieri out there. And the first period comes to a close. A spirited first period between the Islanders and Rangers. Ends in a scoreless tie.
Love the energy and the commitment. And really, they were engaged in every possible facet. So a real good play by the by the Islanders. Well committed, Brendan. And we talked about them playing a simple, smart game. That's exactly what they did in the third.
Coming up, it is the first intermission report brought to you by your local Honda dealers. Cal Clutterbuck will be our guest here at UBS Arena. Shannon Hogan is standing by, and we take a look back at the opening weekend here at UBS Arena. No wins in the opening two games, but still plenty to celebrate for this Islanders franchise here in their brand new building. Islanders, Rangers, an awfully good first. Lots of physical contact, couple of chances, no score after one.
You're watching the Honda Intermission Report. Islanders and Rangers. It's 0-0 after 20 minutes of play. First time these two teams are meeting here at UBS Arena. The new home of the New York Islanders, UBS Arena at Belmont Park, is now open. And the official app of the arena is live, too. Download the UBS Arena app today to purchase and store tickets on your phone. You can get access to unique Islanders content and so much more. To download the app today, go to ubsarena.com/app. We had a chance to catch up with Cal Clutterbuck as he was coming off the ice. Let's take a listen. Cal, thanks for your time. 10 regulars out of the lineup when you add up the injuries and the guys that are on the COVID protocol list right now. What was the message heading into this first period?
Keep it simple. Obviously, a lot of guys new to this, and we are too, so keep it simple, keep it moving forward. Try and get pucks on net, get people there.
Pretty solid first period for your team, especially all things considered. What stood out to you about the way you guys were playing?
I think we were just quick on the puck. Did a good job insulating in our own zone. Killed a couple penalties. Power play looked a little bit better. And then, that's it.
Pretty physical first period, especially with the Rangers there. When you look at this Rangers team, they're coming in pretty hot to this game tonight. What is the biggest challenge so far that you've seen with them?
I think the biggest challenge with them is their skill players and their speed through the middle of the ice. So I thought we did a pretty good job with that.
All right, Cal, thanks so much for your time. Good luck the rest of the way. We're stepping out for a quick break here live at UBS Arena. When we return, showing you all the excitement of calling this new place home. That's next. are scoreless after one period of play. The newest collection of Islanders gear just dropped at Isles Lab. You're taking a look inside the Isles Lab, and it is coming just in time for the holiday season. Purchase new jerseys, hats, collectibles, and so much more, and give the gift of Islanders memorabilia this year. Trust me, everybody will be grateful for it. To shop the latest, you can visit IslesLab.com today. So, yes, the Islanders have not found a way to pick up a win in their new home here at UBS Arena, but that doesn't mean that it wasn't a spectacular weekend. It really was. I think for everybody that came through the doors here and saw this new arena firsthand, they understand how special this new home is. And for the fans at home, you need to get some tickets. Make sure you come here. Check out the Islanders. They're excited about their new home as well. Brendan Burke put a lovely poem together to explain how a lot of us are feeling.
...1255 Hempstead Turnpike in Uniondale is now 2400 Hempstead Turnpike in Elmont. UBS Arena at Belmont Park. Welcome home, Islander fans. And you can write home in ink this time. The headline here is an NHL team opens new arena. It's so much more than that to so many people. For so many fans and for so many years, this is a moment that they never believed would happen. Year after year after year, that idea was only reinforced. It's a 30-year saga that is hard to explain, harder to believe, and impossible to truly understand, except by Islander fans who live through it. This is a celebration of a new era of Islanders hockey, a new feeling of stability, a shift in perception and perspective, a new beginning. In this case, the end is just as important as the beginning. The closure, as important as the opening. It's the end of the uncertainty, the instability. It's the end of the relocation threats and jokes. It's the end of the worry, that thought in the back of your mind that just wouldn't go away. From the Lighthouse Project to Barclays Center, there is an entire generation of Islander fans that don't know a time when the Islanders' home wasn't in question. Exhale. It's over. It's all over. This is the home the franchise deserves. A world-class, state-of-the-art hockey palace with the Nassau County zip code. We are 8 miles west of Nassau Coliseum. The banners are in the rafters, hung at nearly an identical height as they were in the building where they were won. But that's about where the similarities end with the Coliseum. And that's not a bad thing, because the Coliseum was never about the building. It wasn't about the ceiling height. It was about the people that filled it and the feeling inside of it. Both of those are present at UBS Arena. So enjoy the game. Enjoy whatever this moment means to you. But know that for the first time and forever, the only thing Islander fans have to worry about is a hockey game.
So well said by Brendan Burke, and a big thanks to our friends at Isles TV for helping to put that together as well. I think you really hit the nail on the head there. So many people came up to the set, wandered around the arena today, and they all have the same expression. Yes, this place is wonderful, but it's also a sense of relief and also of being so grateful, which seems totally fitting as we are leading up to Thanksgiving, which is tomorrow. And we here at MSG Networks are, of course, so thankful for all of you for being a part of our family, watching the Islanders games right here. We couldn't do it without you. This Islanders team knows they can't do it without you either. We're going to take a quick break, and we're going to have more from UBS Arena. How about that hair? Islanders and Rangers, the main event tonight. Still scoreless. Islanders are the main event. Islanders hoping to keep up the energy that they had in that first period. And now it's time to check the line, presented by FanDuel Sportsbook. Make every moment more. Turn inching closer to puck drop in the second period action with Brendan and Butch.
Matchup brought to you by BMW. Each team with 8 shots, each goalie with 8 saves. We are scoreless after one period of play. Just about to start period number 2 here at UBS Arena.
Tonight's Cadillac trivia question. The Islanders went 6-2 in 8 meetings last season against the Rangers. In those 6 wins, how many Islanders goals or Ranger goals were scored against the Islanders in those 6 games? Tune in to see tonight's Cadillac trivia reveal and tweet your answer to hashtag Cadillac trivia reveal.
Not a lot.
That's correct. Islanders Rangers getting set here for period 2 at UBS Arena. Brendan Burke and Butch Goring along with you as well. Varlamov against Shesterkin. Barzal will take the faceoff at center ice against Barclay Goodrow. We get a penalty right off the opening faceoff. Islanders are going to be shorthanded.
Parise got his stick right in the midsection of Rooney. And he's going to go to the sin bin. And I'm a little surprised that
getting Barzal for it.
I thought it was Parise personally, but it doesn't matter. I mean, can't take a face-off. Can't lose a face-off and then take a penalty. I mean, my goodness, Barry Trotz has got to be like, what are we doing? See, I thought it was Parise myself, but let's just see what happens here. Yep. Well, got a little hook on the glove. That's not a good penalty.
So power play for the Rangers with a clean sheet of ice here to start the second. Adam Fox moves and shoots. It was tipped by Zibanejad. Came off the glass. Strome found it. Varlamov couldn't track it. Now it's out for Panarin. To Fox straight away. Right side Strome. Goal line. Chance. They score. Chris Kreider with a nifty little tap in at the side of the net. A power play goal. His 14th goal of the season. And the Rangers strike early here in the second period.
That was the set play as Kreider has scored a couple just like that where he gets off to the side and a little deflection and Varlamov doesn't get over and shut it down. Good puck movement by the Rangers. Number 20 in front. Look at him slide right over. And then Varlamov just drops down, Brendan, instead of sliding. Following the puck all the way. Watch him just drop down. And a nice little deflection by Kreider. We highlighted him at the top of the show and talking about how good he is around the net. He's become one of the premier net front present guys. Certainly power play goals for him, having a big year.
14th goal in the season. 9 of the 14 have been on the power play. Those 9 power play goals tied for the NHL lead with Leon Draisaitl. I mean, 9 goals leads the Islanders, and that's Brock Nelson, who's out for the next 2 to 4 weeks. He's just done that on the power play here in what is 18-plus games to start the season for Chris Kreider.
He's been hot.
This is offside here. Aho and Rooney a little late to get that message. But the Islanders take a penalty off the opening faceoff of the second period. And all of a sudden, after a decent first push, they're going to chase the game.
Well, I'm interested to see when does Barzal get back on the ice again, because Barry will not be happy with that. I mean, and he shouldn't be. I mean, there was no reason to do that, as a matter of fact. You know, everybody's in position. He's not going to score from outside the blue line and put your team in a bad spot. And you're right. Now it's going to give the Rangers just a little jump. Rangers didn't have as much jump as the Islanders, I thought, in the first period.
The Islanders missing almost half of their normal lineup as Palmieri throws it to the net. It's covered up by Shesterkin, or at least that's what he thought. The whistles do come now, but if you're keeping track at home, the injury bug has hit Ryan Pulock, Brock Nelson, both out long-term. Noah Dobson was ruled out with an injury today, lower body, and then the 7 guys on the COVID list. Josh Bailey, Anders Lee, Ross Johnston, Kiefer Bellows, Adam Pellick, Andy Green, and Zdeno Chara all out of the lineup for the Islanders tonight.
Good thing you didn't have any more names because you didn't have time.
Beauvillier steps and shoots. That one never made it to the net. Kreider picks it up, and he can fly. Kreider has Kako breaking. Hits the trailers of Banajad instead. They try to return it. They got it there. And Kreider couldn't direct it on goal. Fox mishandled, and it comes to center. So we are seeing some season debuts for Islanders tonight. Otto Koivula is up from Bridgeport. So is Paul Ledoux. Both of them are making their season debut. Anatoly Golashev was called up as well, but he is a healthy scratch in this game. He did take warm-ups. Varlamov shovels it over. Speaking of Islanders' debuts, at least this season, Thomas Hickey out there for New York. As Hickey and Ledoux paired up together here tonight. Paul Ledoux Long pass for Cizikas. They say he didn't touch it, and so this is ruled an icing.
Brendan, you and I were talking earlier on about who has the most experience on the back end for the Islanders, and it would surprise you who has more games than anybody else.
Thomas Hickey not only has more games than everybody else, Thomas Hickey has played more games in the National Hockey League than the other five defensemen combined. 454 games for Thomas Hickey, 402 for the other five, and 301 of those belong to Scott Mayfield. That's the kind of experience the Islanders have on their back end here tonight.
I would say that means there's very little with the other guys on the team. And Thomas Hickey's always been a guy, that a real smart hockey player, and plays a solid game in his own end. It just became a numbers game for him more than anything else.
And he just drew a penalty.
Ryan Strome.
Against his old teammate. Ryan Strome will head to the penalty box for the second time in this game, as he's called for tripping on Hickey. And the Islanders will get a chance to answer the Rangers' power play goal with one of their own.
Well, Ryan Strome was a good player for the Islanders. One thing about Ryan Strome is that he had good hands. Watch the penalty. That's Hickey kind of. Well, there's the kind of the little trip in the legs. But Ryan Strome was always a guy, Brendan, that made decisions in a hurry. He's a great passer. He sees something, he reacts. And he's fit in really well with this Rangers. He struggled with Edmonton, but he's been a really good player with the Rangers.
Yeah, he has found a home right next to Artemi Panarin. Seems to have something together. You know, Butch, sometimes those elite players can be hard to find the right match. And Ryan Strome appears to be the right match. So it is a power play for the Islanders as Beauvillier just shanked the pass and leads to an easy clear for Barclay Goodrow.
Looked like he just didn't make up his mind what he wanted to do. Did he want to shoot it or did he want to pass it? A little miscommunication there again.
Islanders trying to answer the power play goal from Chris Kreider. Strome and Fox got assists on the Ranger power play goal 29 seconds into the period as Barzal's pass blocked down by Fox, who reaches for his mouth. He may have gotten a puck up high. Aho for Barzal. Back to Aho. Moves, looks, nothing there. Feeds Beauvillier. Beauvillier had a path to net, cut off. Nothing happening.
Hey, somebody's got to move for him, find a hole.
They open it up for Beauvillier. Big rebound, kicked out by Ponick. It will not go. Beauvillier finds the loose puck, twists it out for Aho. Minute to go on the power play with Strome in the box. Beauvillier switching places with Aho. Long change here in the second as well. The all Ranger killers that started are still out there as Beauvillier keeps it down for Barzal. Matt Barzal has a couple of Rangers looking after him. Barzal feeds it, gets it back from Pageau. Aho doesn't shoot. Moves, now does. That one rockets off the glass. Fox looking to clear. Slowed up and then helped down the ice by Goodrow. And the Rangers will be able to make that change.
Well, Rangers a good job of staying in the shooting lanes, and Islanders couldn't find any holes. Aho did get the puck to the net a couple of times. They had one pretty near opportunity.
15 seconds to go on the power play. Parisi gains the line. Shesterkin out of his net, couldn't stop it. Otto Koivula, who's had a great start in the American Hockey League with Bridgeport, out there on the Islander power play. Palmieri, Salo, wrist shot, tap, save Shesterkin. Strome comes out of the box as Rooney picks up the puck. Islanders changing defensively. Rooney carries in. Good hustle back by Parisi, but they find the trailing Trouba. Trouba taken out of the play by Koivula. And Robin Salo up with the puck for the Isles. Knocked down by Mayfield. He's able to spring Wahlstrom. Wahlstrom just one-hands it in, and Trouba turns it back around for Strome. Strome working wide, pinched off by Salo. Puck available there for Lafreniere. Mayfield able to wrestle it from him. 5 minutes gone here in the second period. Lafreniere delivered the hit that sent Salo down to the ice. This will be icing, though, at the Rangers' expense.
Good action out there. I mean, both teams, a lot of pace to their game. Islanders get the puck towards the net. Everybody's scrambling. There's a good shot there with Parise. Beauvillier gets a shot away. Nice save by Shesterkin. He's out of position, and he gets a lucky bounce that the Islanders can't hang on to it. And good hit by Lafreniere there with the rookie on Salo. Got to be ready for those scenarios, Brendan. Don't let up.
Barzal tossed out of the faceoff. And so Richard Ponick, who's played plenty of center in his NHL career, will stand in.
Turns the hand around, Brendan.
And he wins it cleanly back. Hickey for Barzal. Popped out, Ponick did to the slot. Barzal trying to work his way through Julian Gauthier. Parisi and the rookie Nils Lundqvist battling there. Now Barzal comes over. He's toppled over by Hedl. Islanders are going to get another chance at the power play.
That's a good call as he jammed the stick in his feet. Earlier on, you mentioned it, Brendan Barzal had Ponick right in the middle of the slot area and chose not to pass it or didn't see him. But good hard work by Parise to one-on-one and sticks on the leg. That's a tough call, but I'm sure Gallant's not too happy. And you know what? He's got a legitimate argument there. I don't know that was a great penalty. Not all penalties are great, though.
Well, the Islanders will have yet another opportunity. This power play has really struggled here over the month of November. Pageau has been incredible on faceoffs tonight. This one's up for grabs off the draw in the Islanders' offensive zone. And win, lose, or draw, it stays in the Rangers' end for the moment, although Shesterkin does a nice job to send it all the way.
He has time, and he's going to be able to ice that puck. Well, a lot of the goalies these days shoot the puck almost as hard as the players.
So here come the Islanders through center with a man advantage. Barzal met there by Lindgren, shoved down to the ice, but he made the pass to Aho. Right side, Pageau. Aho waiting with it. Now Beauvillier drifting out high. Barzal, Aho, one timer, just missed.
That looked like it might have hit the post the way it caromed.
Fox trying to clear. Ponick unable to keep it alive as it's sent back towards Varlamov. And a lot of this Islander unit is Barzal on the long feed, has Koivula going to the net, and he lost the handle. Barzal couldn't get Koivula. He turned to look for Wahlstrom, and then he coughed it up.
Yeah, he was about standing still trying to stick handle.
You could make a pretty good power play unit for the Islanders out of the guys that aren't on the ice tonight.
Yeah, that you can.
Here is Palmieri, Anders Lee, Brock Nelson, Josh Bailey, Ryan Pulock, as Wahlstrom sidesteps a hit from Kreider, hands off for Robin Salo. Now Palmieri. Palmieri shoots, saves Shesterkin. He didn't let that puck hit the ice with Parisi sniffing around.
All right, in the midsection, Shesterkin had a good look, long look at it. Positioned himself extremely well. And Barzal gets it to Aho. This is a good shot. And that's going on. Dinged off the post, off the glove, off the post. Huh? Yeah, and then Barzal. Again, watch where he just stops skating, and now he's in trouble because he's got nowhere to go with it. And then the Islanders, again, all the way around the horn, get that puck towards the net, but Shesterkin's got really good position and going to be tough to score from there.
25 seconds left on what is the fourth power play of the game for the Islanders. As Wahlstrom carries in, Wahlstrom almost deked himself out of it.
On his heels, wasn't he?
Yep. Wahlstrom stepped into that one, but it ricochets over for Trouba. And he will curl and play keep away from the Islanders that are down to just 3 seconds left on the Edelmeyer.
And again, nothing great happening on the power play. Not Shesterkin, one ting off the glove, off the post, and then that really was it.
Credited with two saves, Shesterkin, that is, during the Islander power play. As Hickey will pinch in, moves it for Cizikas. Down low, Clutterbuck. Martin parked in front. Clutterbuck with a little bit of room. Plays for Grant Hutton. Cizikas, backhand. Fluttering puck just outside the blue paint. Played to the wall. Hutton tried to smash it back to the net. As Matt Martin retrieves his stick, Cizikas shoved down. Puck there with Hutton. Comes away for Strome. Rink wide for Panarin, and he'll wait with it. And fire back over.
It's going to be icing, Brennan. Yep.
Strome couldn't reach it. Lines up across the goal line, and it's icing.
You know you could bet on the 60-minute correct score of the game on FanDuel Sportsbook. Make every moment more and get in on the action now with FanDuel.
Rangers lead it 1-0 on a power play goal from Chris Kreider in the opening minute of this second period. Shots, though, just 12-10 in favor of the Islanders here almost halfway through regulation time.
Both teams have checked very, very well and been able to keep each other to the outside, but solid effort, really, when you talk about, you know, energy from the teams. They've been on their toes. They've worked hard along the boards.
Paul Murray surveys the scene, snaps a pass, trying to get it through for Beauvillier. It's deflected out of the zone.
Again, we talked about Rangers and Islanders getting the sticks in the passing lanes, and there was a good example.
Shesterkin wrapped around the boards. Paul Ledoux able to pinch in and keep Panarin from advancing. Squirts over for Lundqvist, and now Miller. Return for Nils Lundqvist, the lone rookie in the lineup for the New York Rangers, made his NHL debut on opening night. Panarin backhands it through the neutral zone. Ledoux beaten to the puck by the long reach of Kaapo Kakko. Mayfield and Hedl got together. Otto Koivula comes away with it.
Good play there by Koivula.
Koivula for Mayfield up on the rush. The pass was in his skates. It rolls out. Andreev with a shot. Save made. No rebound from Shesterkin. As a pileup just outside the crease. After a little contact between Mayfield and Shesterkin as Mayfield was driving to the net. Boy, there have been no rebounds from Igor Shesterkin tonight. One of the reasons the Isles are down 1-0. Only a couple of NHL games over the past couple of years. He's from North Dakota, both the state and the university, but a lot of learning on the fly on the bench tonight for the Islanders.
Well, when you're in a, you know, very unique situation, this is a high-intensity game, a big rivalry game, and you know, he's just trying to figure it out and say, okay, how do these guys play? How fast are they? And that's John Gruden, the defensive coach, and one of the coaches, and just going over a couple of things, and you can see Hutton listening in on the play, but as you mentioned, Brendan, you can never stop learning. This is a very, very fast game, so they're talking about situations and how to handle it.
All previous NHL experience for Ledoux with the Los Angeles Kings. Grant Hutton, this is NHL game number 3 for him after his call-up from Bridgeport. Kaapo Kakko shoots this one in to Hutton's corner. Played around for Hickey. Parisi dealing with Kakko. Kakko's pass ricochets off of Ponick. And out the center.
Parise never gives up on the play, does he? I mean, he only knows how to play one way, and it's all out. He's all about work.
Zibanejad had it lifted from him by Hutton. A couple of change of directions for Hutton. And Hickey with lots of room.
Well, guys like Hutton and Salo will get more and more confidence with more and more ice time, more and more games.
Parisi and Barzal working down low. Forced to the front. Ponick couldn't reach it. Kakko chips it right across a dangerous area, but it got through for Panarin. And he chops it in wide. Panarin continues it on for Trouba. Trouba got rid of it just as Clutterbuck came to him. Barzal stick check Panarin. Clutterbuck lifted ahead. Wanted Matt Martin, overshot him, and it's an icing against the Isles. It's now time for the live odds presented by FanDuel Sportsbook. Make every moment more.
Scott Mayfield complaining a little bit that he's got tape on his pads and the referee is saying he's got to go. But, you know, that's an equipment issue. Just drop it on the ice, Mayfield. That's what I would do. You're rushing me. Here, you're not going to help me? I'll just drop it on the ice.
So you can see he's lost the tape on his left shin guard, which virtually holds that in place.
Yeah, I mean,
it's a loose sock, but the tape is what secures that to where it needs to be. So something to watch for here. He'll get off the ice as soon as he can, and Barzal rushing ahead will allow him to do so.
And there he goes. Retape.
Matt Martin just outmuscled Keandre Miller there, but couldn't secure the puck in the process. Dryden Hunt for the Rangers will shoot it in.
Good skater, very good shot, just plays hard, plays a physical game. Nothing fancy about his game.
Trouba shoots, toe saved by Varlamov. Back out for Miller. Played over for Trouba, blocked by a diving Matt Martin. Hickey hunting for the puck. Clutterbuck clears the zone. And the Islanders survive, thanks in part to a shot block from Matt Martin.
Talk about sacrificing the body there, boy. Cizikas line does it all the time. And
what a forecheck by Cizikas there on Miller.
Just stayed strong, didn't he?
Puck comes to him as a result. Looks off a pass, nothing at the top. He finds Ledoux. Move quickly to Hickey. Hickey snaps one through. It was tipped by Clutterbuck, but wide. Thrown off the outside of the net. Pageot quickly to it. He got stapled by Truman. Penalty here. I believe it's against the Islanders. They're going to get Pageot for a high stick. So the Rangers will go on another power play. Up 1-0 on a power play goal. Brought to you by BMW Special Teams. The theme of this game so far, Chris Kreider, 9th power play goal, the only goal of the game. Islanders have had 4 power plays, none successful. Goaltenders doing their jobs as well. Islanders about to be killing a penalty. Does Pageau's stick actually hit Panarin?
And watch Panarin's head, though, to help it out. Watch this delayed. Oh, yeah, he got me. Is that selling it? I guess it is. What's the referee's hand? See when he calls it? And there it goes. After the little nod of the head, and he got me. And look at Barry Trotz is not happy with that call.
And listen, we got to slow it down. We got to take a look at it. Referees got to do it real time, live, and you can understand the call. Here's Strome with a slap pass. That one deflected just wide off the net. Eric Furlatt, Michael Markovic are the referees in the game tonight as Clutterbuck gets it cleared on what is the 8th power play of the game already. Each team has had 4. We're not too far past the halfway point of regulation time.
The Rangers do a really good job of getting themselves open in the slot area, whether it's the high or the low slot area. They get deflections going towards the net.
Rangers are 1-for-3 on the power play. Chris Kreider with the goal in the opening shift. Realistically, of this second period, Rangers haven't generated much since then. Just one shot in the last 11 plus minutes of game action for the Rangers. Panarin's pass. Stop. Parisi shoots it down.
And they close them off. Panarin going through the middle of the ice and didn't get anything done there. There's too many skates and sticks. And the Islanders able to clear it again. Very tight box through the neutral zone, the Islanders.
55 left on the Ranger power play. Comes around for Lundqvist. Here's Kako for Lundqvist. Over to Adam Fox. Norris Trophy winner last year in his second season in the National Hockey League. To Kako. Kreider tried to jam in front for Zibanejad. Hickey got enough of that. Fox over. Back from Lundqvist. Fox waiting. Now Kako makes his move. Drifting. Shooting. That one skipped up off the stick of Zibanejad. Stopped and smothered by Varlamov.
Again, finding the opening. But the slot area, Zibanejad, a very smart hockey player, and you can see where in front of the net, Mayfield doesn't really have anybody. So if you're anticipating a little bit when that shot's coming, you've got to be aware of where that man is there, number 93, be able to see where everybody else is on the ice. Force him to pass it to the outside, I always say, Brendan. And you get him outside the dots, you got a pretty good chance of being able to stop the play.
Otto Koivula wins an important faceoff for New York.
He's been good. He's been solid out there. I mean, we've seen him before, but it seems like some time in the American Hockey League has helped Koivula. Been strong on faceoffs, and his clearing plays have been good.
He had 15 points in 17 games down in the American Hockey League level with the Bridgeport Islanders. As the Islanders, J.G. Pageot, one of their penalty killers, just finished serving a 2-minute minor. He's out of the box. Islanders, if they hurry, have a 3-on-2. Koivula, Pageot, and Palmieri. Pageot to Palmieri, and it rolled off his stick.
Lifted his head up, and then the puck bounced on him. Didn't cradle it, I guess, well enough.
Koivula backhands it towards the front. It got wrapped up there in the pads of Shesterkin. And he draws the whistle. 5:55 left on the clock here in the second. Still just a 1-0 Ranger lead.
Got to be a member here. So much to explore. You have all kinds of food on the 100 level. I want to show you inside the Dime Club, which is fantastic. You definitely want to be a member here. So much to explore. You have all kinds of food options, a very long bar on the other side. This is 100 level, looking across from the players' benches. Big bar here. And I somehow feel like Butch Goring is going to be over at the dessert bar, maybe during the second intermission.
Oh, I don't know if that's a fair comment. It could very well be true. Somebody tweeted out the other day, I had the apple crumb cake or whatever the heck it was, and it was good too, Brendan.
Yeah, right on the other side of that big bar that Shannon was showing is us.
Yeah.
We've got a great spot here.
Oh, yeah. Tremendous spot. As we said in the opening show, no excuses for us.
Nope. Here's Wahlstrom open for Ledoux, and he whiffs on a shot. As the Rangers clear it out, and then blowing a tire, there was Wahlstrom nearly. An odd man rush for the Rangers. Turned over by Koivula. Goudreau for Ryan Reeves. Has Rooney breaking. That one tipped on. Goal, they score! Rooney with the tap-in. The Rangers with a 2-0 lead.
Incredible. Just incredible. The decision-making and guys on the ice, a lot of inexperience. Great play, and then throw it back out in front, and it's like the Islanders put that one in their own net. As in front is Ledoux, and no, it's Rooney gets in there, and the guys are slow to get back. And that's like salt on the wounds, Brendan. I mean, you're on a power play, and again, the Islanders give up another shorthanded goal. Nope, even strength goal.
Yeah, even strength goal. But still a 2-0 lead for the Rangers as Kevin Rooney scores for the fourth time this season after a couple of turnovers in the neutral zone by the Islanders. And the Rangers make them pay. Rangers really weren't generating much.
Zero.
Even strength before that shot. Only four shots in the game came at even strength. Most of their offensive chances to come on their four power plays, including their only goal before that one from Rooney. Here's Trouba, whips on a shot out of the position was Varlamov, but up to a strong defensive play to tie up the stick of Strome.
Got back into it as Strome was wide open for a half a second, and Hutton stayed right with it. But as Barry has talked about, you know, you can't continue to keep beating yourself. When you turn the puck over, you give up a 3-on-2. You don't play it very well, and now you're down two goals. And you're struggling to score goals, whether you're on the power play or whether you're 5-on-5.
Islanders coming into this game on a six-game losing streak with six total goals scored in those six games.
Well over 100 minutes since the last time they scored a goal. And now the Rangers have got all kinds of momentum and making it life a little bit more difficult for the Isles.
Kako on the exchange for Zibanejad off the skate of Aho as they attempted to feed Chris Kreider. It's been almost 114 minutes into the last Islander goal. That's in game action. Islander shutout by Joseph Wall in the Toronto Maple Leafs on Sunday here at UBS Arena after a 5-2 loss on Saturday to open the building to Calgary. That game featured two empty net goals by the Flames. Really a 3-2 tight game throughout. Ended with a 5-2 final score.
Yeah, very good game by the Islanders, all things being equal. They deserved better, but the Maple Leafs completely outplayed them in the next game.
Hedl wrapped it to the front. Came right to Parisi. Headmans for Barzell. Fox took it from him. Mayfield followed it up, trying to hit Barzell with a pass. It winds up being an icing instead. After this, it'll be Friday night. A little break from the turkey. Friday at MSG Plus, the Isles take on the Penguins. Live coverage begins 7 p.m. with Islanders game night. Puck drop at 7:30 Friday on MSG Plus. Presented by Mount Sinai South Nassau, or stream it on MSG Go. That'll wrap up the four-game homestand for the Islanders, and then they'll see these Rangers again on Sunday at Madison Square Garden. Richard Ponick, his pass redirected by Hedl. Mayfield tipped in by Matt Barzell. Lafreniere couldn't get a stick on that, but it'll roll on through and force Robin Salo to go get it.
That was a good pinch by Mayfield, and the linesman correctly waved off the potential icing, but not this one.
Nope. So we'll come back for a faceoff near Semyon Varlamov, who has allowed two goals on 14 shots each team, with 14 shots so far in this hockey game, which is closing in rapidly on the end of the second period.
Tough plays on both goals for Varlamov. A power play goal, good deflection by Kreider, and then a 3-on-2 and a loose puck. And a fortuitous bounce for the Rangers, and Rooney just has to tap it in like it's a one-foot putt.
Miller to the net, never got there. Rooney up with it. Now for the Rangers. Mayfield throws the hit. Salo looking to clear. Got it as far as a step outside the blue line. Miller's pass to Ryan Reeves comes back after it. And Reeves dumps the puck in and throws a hit on Salo.
We knew that was happening.
Ryan Reeves, that wrecking ball mentality. You can usually hear when he's on the ice.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you have to know when he's on the ice. I mean, because he's a big man and he's a physical guy. So you've got to be aware when he's there so you protect yourself. Don't put yourself in a bad spot.
Ryan Reeves, a former St. Louis Blues draft pick, climbed his way up through the minor leagues and has become a very coveted piece. Seems like every offseason a different team says, you know what, we need a Ryan Reeves type of guy. And they wind up going to get Ryan Reeves. One of the reasons why the New York Rangers went and got Ryan Reeves this offseason was a direct result of the incident with Tom Wilson and Artemi Panarin just a couple of days after the last Islander Ranger game last season.
And no question that played a big part in it, and the fact that the Islanders ran him out of the building for six periods of hockey at the end of the season. So the decision was made. We've got to get more physical. I don't know if they are any more physical. I mean, yeah, Ryan Reeves is there, but I think overall, I mean, they're bigger defense, Brendan. They picked up some size on defense.
Have you seen the touches of a Gerard Gallant coach team on this team quite yet? Although we're getting a penalty here.
Interference?
Or interference.
Not sure who the penalty is against.
Now, hopefully against the Rangers, because Varlamov is on his way to the bench, and that would have been bad.
And Ryan Strome, his third penalty is a... You know, he better send the referees room maybe a dozen beer or something, Brendan, because he's on the bad side of these two guys, because they anytime he does anything, he's in the penalty box.
Here's Gerard Gallant.
Yeah.
And here's the interference call against Strome. It'll be at the top of the screen. Yeah, just got the skates out from underneath Anthony Beauvillier without the puck.
Gallant likes a team that's physical, Brendan, finishes their checks, and like every coach, wants them to work hard. I thought he did a very good job in Florida when he was there.
Pretty good job in Vegas, too.
Yeah, he did. And they went right to the finals in his first year. That's pretty good.
Islanders on the power play for the fifth time tonight. 0-for-4 with four shots as Palmieri makes his move. 2 minutes to go in the period. Winds its way around for Oliver Wahlstrom. Got a couple of power play goals this year, does Wahlstrom. Pajot steps, shoots, gloves, saves Shesterkin.
It looked a little unsteady. Pajot had a real good look there, going top glove. Shesterkin was able to maintain his position pretty well. Didn't go down early, so the Islanders fighting in the corner for the loose puck. Eventually he's going to come out to Pajot, and he goes right to the middle of the ice. Takes a little look and got the high glove. It's almost like every goaltender that faces off against a right-handed shot, Brendan, keeps his glove up high because he knows where the right-handers want to go. They want to go high glove. And Shesterkin, you can see how high his glove was on that particular shot.
Another important face-off for Pajot. Instead, it's won by Zibanejad, and the Islanders would chase. Minute 20 left on the Strome penalty. 21 seconds left in the period when the penalty expires. Should it reach its full potential? Barzal winds it up through the neutral zone. Barzal to the outside, puck on edge, he jams on the brakes, feeds Aho. Aho on the move, drifting, back across for Barzal. Nothing there. Now Aho again, rips a shot just wide. Pajot may have gotten a piece, wound up off the backboards, Beauvillier can't hold it in.
Yeah, one and done, not enough. Gotta try and make sure he makes himself available. Has to get those rebounds, and that's dangerous.
Final minute of the period
last
here.
Minute of the period.
39 seconds to go on the power play. Barzal gains the line with help from Palmieri. Now Barzal looking to get it back. Gets tangled up with Fox, who's dropped his stick. Lindgren came over. Palmieri pries it away from him, but off of Wahlstrom sticking out to center.
Wouldn't surprise me if the Boo Birds come out, Brendan. I mean, again, five power plays, and Islanders are looking like they're going 0-for-5.
12 seconds left to change that. Wahlstrom wanted Barzal, and Fox is there again. Turnover, Wahlstrom alone, lost it on the backhand. Never got a shot away. Strome coming out of the box. 20 seconds to go on the period. Look out, Strome. They feed him the pass. Mayfield catches up to him, but Varlamov makes a fine save.
Yeah, Strome couldn't get it up. He couldn't get the leverage that he wanted. Mayfield came back hard. Tremendous play by Scott Mayfield, not to take a penalty, but just... You just can't believe what the Islanders are doing with their offensive chances, can you? I mean, they just mishandle it time after time.
Well, there are 17,255 fans here. That's a sellout at UBS Arena. Not all of them are happy. Some of them are, because some of them are Ranger fans. But, boy, on a platter for Oliver Wahlstrom here.
Yeah, was a turnover, and he just mishandles it. And, you know, perfect opportunity. And there's the breakaway play. Scott Mayfield coming hard. Gets a little stick on him, a little loose hand. Didn't call a penalty. Good break there. And Varlamov aggressive enough. And Barry tries his. I can only imagine what he's thinking. I mean, my goodness. His team is just having such a tough time. I mean, they get chances to score, Brendan, and they handle the puck like it's a brick.
Coming up, it's the second intermission of Port, brought to you by your local Ford stores. Visit buyfordnow.com today. We will hear from Kyle Palmieri, who's been involved in these five Islander power plays. And Butch Goring helps break down the first 40 minutes of play as the Islanders see the Rangers score twice in the middle frame. Chris Kreider on the power play just 29 seconds in. Kevin Rooney at 14:28. The two Ranger goals. They lead it 2-0. Headed to the third tonight on Long Island.
Ford intermission report. Isles and Rangers, first time they're meeting at UBS Arena at Belmont Park. And so far, the Rangers are up 2-0 on the New York Islanders. Had a chance to catch up with Kyle Palmieri as he was coming off the ice. Kyle, an early goal in that second period for the Rangers. What does that do for some of the momentum and the energy that you guys were able to build in the first period and then try to carry over into the second?
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. We just got to stay with it, and we got to have a big third here.
Five power play opportunities for the Islanders. You've been doing your best to help them get on the score sheet there with the man advantage. What are you guys looking at? I mean, it's tough right now trying to get the goals when things just don't seem to be going your way. But what is the focus of the power play if you get another opportunity?
Yeah, I mean, obviously you can't score if you don't put the puck there. So continue to do that and find the second and third opportunities and get one by them.
Kyle, with so many new guys in the lineup, it seems like every night there's some kind of change. Have there been conversations in the room? Have you talked to a couple of the younger guys coming up of just how you guys like to play Islanders hockey and what's going to take to win one of these games?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, all those guys were there for training camp. They've been here for a couple training camps. So they know the way we play. And, you just continue to talk to them. Make sure they're thinking positively. And we're just going to go out there and work and try and climb back into this.
All right, Kyle, thanks so much for your time. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
We're stepping out for a quick break, but plenty more to come in our Ford intermission report. Butch Goring joins us next when we return. You're watching the Ford intermission report, Isles and Rangers, and we've got fans of both teams here at UBS Arena at Belmont Park. Rangers up 2-0. Isles definitely not out of this game, though. They're hoping to have a strong third period. There's been some spotty play from them and some flashes of some good stuff. We want to bring in Butch Goring to talk about some of those bright spots so far and what they need to do to clean up. Butch? Butchie! I told you to have the dessert. I didn't think you were going to do it for our segment, Butchie.
Well, you were giving me a little stuff and about my dessert ability.
What is it? What did you end up getting? Is it cake?
It's an apple crumb cake of sorts. And it's really good, Shannon.
And a rainbow cookie?
And I'm not sharing with you.
Okay, so it's fine.
Yeah,
it's fine. All right. Tomorrow's a big day. We'll have plenty to feast on for Thanksgiving. Let's talk a little business, Butchie. You know, this is an Islander team, and you, Brenda, have been talking about it. They had a lot of power play opportunities. I know it's been frustrating for them. We heard from Kyle Palmieri not being able to capitalize. But what about a bright spot? The first time we're seeing Otto Koivula this season, we've seen him over the years up and down, and, you know, it's kind of a a showcase for him to jump into the lineup and prove that maybe he could be more regular with the Islanders.
Well, he's played very well in the American Hockey League, and you're right. It's not his first run at the or first rodeo, no doubt about it. And he's really shown that he's an improved hockey player. He looks like he's got a little more quickness to his game. He certainly has a little more strength. Good on faceoffs, and Barry Trotz is relying on him more and more all the time. I mean, this is an opportunity for a lot of these guys with so many of the regulars out of the lineup. And he's just very, very strong along the boards, got a good stick, and winning one-on-one battles. And listen, you want to play in this league, you want to be a centerman. Well, you've got to be able to help out down low, and you've got to win those battles. So he's had a real good game. And look at the speed down the wing, the strength. Takes a little look over his shoulders. And not a lot of ice time, not as much. But you know what? Barry Trotz will give him more. It's all about confidence. And so this man here is making a real nice impact for not only for the team, but for himself.
Butch, it's an uphill battle for this Islanders team right now. There's only so much they can do. And I think that there's a sense that they know that. I mean, they're in this position. This is what they have to deal with. But what do you think the conversation would be in the room as they head out to do this third period?
Well, I think they're going to be saying, hey, listen, we're doing some good things out there. I mean, we're creating some power play opportunities, and we've got to capitalize on it. These guys are not beating us. We've beaten ourselves a little bit with a couple of mistakes. So I think they feel like, hey, you know what? We've got a chance here where we got to continue to do what we've been doing for the first 40 minutes, and then that's good hard work, simple hockey, and eventually they're going to score a goal. They got to keep getting the puck towards the goaltender Shesterkin, because he's been pretty sharp.
All right, Butchie, I'll let you get back to your dessert.
Yeah, I got to get my dessert.
Enjoy that apple cobbler. I love that you're such a good sport about that. We're looking forward to the call with you and Brendan in the third period as well. We're taking a quick break here on our intermission report. Islanders and Rangers here at UBS. And how about that little puppy? Oh, my gosh. I love the Islanders guide dog. That'll put a smile on anybody's face. We'll be right back after this. Place on Long Island. It offers something for everyone, including public skate sessions, learn to skate and learn to play, youth house leagues, hockey clinics, adult leagues, and so much more. Visit www.northwellhealthicecenter.com for details. It's Northwell Health Ice Center, the coolest place on Long Island. Well, now it's time to check the line, presented by FanDuel Sportsbook. Make every moment more. Take a look at the Hyundai scoring summary. Islanders and Rangers. It's a tight game so far when you look at the score. Chris Kuyter, Kevin Rooney have the goals. Both of those coming in the second period for the Rangers. The first just 29 seconds in, a power play goal for Chris Kuyter with some help from Ryan Strome and Adam Fox there. Shots pretty even on this one, but look at those power play opportunities. Islanders 0-for-5, 1-for-4 for the Rangers. So a lot of time spent here with the man advantage on both sides. Islanders looking to capitalize if they get another chance in the third period. We're taking a break. When we return, Butch will be done with his cake. Brendan will be ready to call the game. That's next.
Rangers, and it's Rangers by 2 at the start of the third. Islanders hockey on MSG Networks. He's presented by Mount Sinai, South Nassau, in Oceanside. We find a way. Let's answer our Cadillac trivia question before we drop the puck here in the third. Islanders won 6 of 8 last year. How many total goals did the Rangers score in those 4 games? Well, 4 of the 6 games were shutouts.
Yes.
3 total goals.
6 games. That's not a lot of offense, and that's probably why the Islanders won, right?
Islanders certainly enjoyed their season series last year with the Rangers. So far, not the same story here tonight. Make sure you tweet your own questions. Use the hashtag Cadillac Trivia.
Hey, but you know what, Brendan? I love those rivalry games. I mean, 6 games to me was not too much. I know the players got a little bit maybe tired of playing the same teams all the time, but It was intense hockey, and that's what hockey should be.
This has been intense hockey here tonight. Has not been a lot of open ice. There's only been 31 shots. That's total so far through 40 minutes. 16 shots for the Islanders, 15 shots for the Rangers. Rangers have the two goals, a power play goal from Chris Kreider, an even strength goal from Kevin Rooney. As the Islanders' scoring struggle continues, the Islanders missing 9 players out of the lineup because of either injury or COVID protocol. This one shot in by Rooney. Mayfield to get it. The only member of the original 6 defensemen to start the season on the ice tonight for the Islanders is Scott Mayfield. Pageau's pass directed in by Beauvillier. Shesterkin let it go behind it. Palmieri jumped all over it. Palmieri for Salem. Spun behind for Beauvillier. Mayfield pinching it. Worked out. Palmieri just able to keep the zone but can't do much with it.
Harold, Brendan, we talked about the lack of scoring for the Islanders, but let's remember that they've got a whole bunch of regulars out of the lineup, and that is a disadvantage.
You would not expect this team to be able to be competitive in the National Hockey League with the roster that they're being forced to dress right now. As Kapokako turns and looks, Zibanejad in the front just missed Chris Kreider. And this is a Ranger team that is playing some very good hockey here off the start of the season. 11-4-3, 25 points in their first 18 games.
And they've been healthy. And that's always critical.
Beauvillier with the poke on Patrick Nemeth. They're missing one player because of injury. It's a big loss, and it's for the season. Sammy Blay is already done for the year for the New York Rangers as Varlamov fights off a point-blank one-timer from Artemi Panarin.
He came in off the bench, and the Islanders weren't able to pick him up.
Beauvillier helps get it out, and the Islanders, after about a minute and a half shift for most of them, able to make a change.
They need a goal at that, I mean, for the Islanders. I mean, it would pick their spirits up and always score a goal. Legs get a little quicker.
There's only one player for the Islanders that has scored a goal here at UBS Arena, and that's Brock Nelson. He scored twice on Saturday, was injured in the first period on Sunday, and is out 2 to 4 weeks with a lower body injury. Here's Matt Barzal. 1-on-3. Barzal got around Miller, got around the net. It was Parisi in front, but two Rangers cut off the pass. Parisi stuffs it to the crease, a second effort chop just wide. Panarin looking to clear, he will. It will be icing as a result.
Ponik had an opportunity. He tried to bat it out of midair. Barzal getting himself going. The Isles have not quit. There's no two ways about it. Parisi looking to try and throw it all the way across. Watch his puck bounce up, and Ponik's not able to handle it. But the thing about Zach, he loves to go to the net with it. Shesterkin gets plenty of help from his D.
Still looking for that first one as an Islander.
Oh, you can imagine just how frustrated he is. It might be the longest streak of his career, just not having anything.
His dad scored a pretty big goal against the Rangers.
Yeah, right
now. This might be a good time for one.
Yeah, Zach would love to score a big goal. Of getting the Isles on the board and closing the gap to one would be a big goal.
Filipetal on the dump in right into the glove of Varlamov, and he will hang on. Faceoff coming in the Islanders' zone. J.P. Parisi, of course, scoring that goal in the playoffs in 1975 in overtime to sink the Rangers.
That was like early in the overtime too, Brendan.
That was 11 seconds in.
Yeah, 11 seconds. Oh, funny. What number does Zach wear?
He joked about how many times he's heard that story from his dad.
I'm sure. You got to make some of your own memories and magic.
His dad, JP, who passed away a few years back. Sure would love to see his son wearing the Islanders colors.
Yeah.
Taking this one wide is Andreoff, dealing with Fox. Puck pulled out of the skates by Wallstrom. Cross ice pass for Aho. That one trickles wide. Back in front. Kogla had a whack at it. Couldn't get it to go. Twisted it to near side. The left-handed Aho playing right defense. Koivula drifting. Shooting. Score! The tip in front. Wallstrom and
aboard and within one.
And they picked the puck up, so I'm thinking it might be Koivula's goal, Brendan. They picked up the puck right away. Who's leading the way? Oh, Andreoff is leading the way, so he must have got a part of it. Take a little look in front of the net. Great play by Koivula, just getting the puck towards the net. Yeah, oh yeah, Andreoff knocks it down. Beautiful deflection. Head up all the way, and good mentality for Koivula. And now the Islanders are back in the hockey game with all the momentum. And that was pretty much a minor league line.
It was.
You know?
Andreoff, Koivula, Wahlstrom with Aho and Hutton were on the ice as the Islanders get within one on the goal for Andy Andreoff, who hadn't scored a goal in the NHL since February 19, 2018, playing for the LA Kings in Chicago that night, icing against the Rangers. Let's take another look at it on our four-goal replay as Andy Andreoff credited with the goal on a beautiful tip.
Nice play by Koivula, though, as he goes up high, stays wide, turns around and fires it towards the net, and you got two Islanders in front of the net, and they able to get a stick on one. Well, we talked about that. Keep shooting the puck and go to the front of the net and take a deflection or a rebound, whatever.
And that puck still might be going home with Otto Koivula. That's his first point in the National Hockey League.
Well, maybe that's what it's about. Maybe that's why they picked up the puck.
He played 12 NHL games, but no points prior. And the Rangers answer right back. Ryan Reeves to Kevin Rooney.
Well, coming down is basically was a two-on-two, and Ledoux left his feet. Now you get, or excuse me, Thomas Hickey and Ledoux, and you can't give up the cross-ice passes. I mean, I talk about it all the time, and Rangers just get it up. Ledoux can't handle the puck, and now it's Hickey with the two-on-one. Slides down. Not a good play by Thomas Hickey. Just stay on your feet. I mean, there's no angle there. Look where he is right now. He's going to make a call. Look, he's below the dots. That's a great play by Ryan Reeves to take it to his backhand and then slide it to Rooney. But that's not a good play by Thomas Hickey. Stay on your feet. My goodness. Let him have shots there all day long, Brendan.
20 seconds between the goals, and the Rangers' lead is right back to two. Zibanejad trying to work around Salo. And this one cleared up off the glass and out to center. So the Islanders finally get a goal, a chance to feel good about it, a chance to build momentum, and they're right back where they started from.
Yeah, mistake at the offensive blue line, and then a really poorly played two-on-one, or two-on-two, really, if you will.
Zibanejad with a stretch pass, wanted Panarin. Mayfield able to redirect it. Aho leaves it off for Scott Mayfield. Parisi can't get his stick away from Lindgren. Crowd wants a call that they won't get. Refs were very involved in the first two periods of this hockey game. As Panarin comes charging in and rips one off to the corner, caroms to Parisi, and he springs Ponick. Richard Ponick sprays some snow, realizing he has nobody with him. He hits a pass for Hickey, over for Hutton. He shoots it off the outside of the net. Came back around for Barzal. Wanted to stuff it in front for Parisi. This one hoisted into the air. It lands right next to Ponick. Grabbed, though, by Hunt and chipped in by Strome. Hutton lined up. His stick broke. He didn't realize that the blade was gone. Now he'll drop it and go to the bench. As Otto Koivula for Wahlstrom. Wahlstrom from no angle. Took a little whack there on the wrist. He is wincing in pain. Play continues as the Rangers shoot it down. Ledoux. And that broken stick back behind the net. Lafreniere over. Lundqvist. Finding some space. Nils Lundqvist with a backhand and able to hug the post and make the save was Varlamov. Islanders and Rangers trade goals 20 seconds apart, and it's 3-1 Rangers. After the game for highlights, analysis, and player reaction, that's coming up on the Mercedes-Benz Islanders post-game show after this one here tonight. Well, three players made their Islanders debut tonight. Paul Ledoux, Thomas Hickey, season debut, that is, getting a chance to play, as well as Otto Koivula. So you've got three players. That's now 28 different skaters for the New York Islanders this season. They only used 27 different skaters all last season, and that includes the trade deadline acquisitions. Zajac, Palmieri, Braden Coburn, all three of those guys. Those are moves you make on purpose, trying to make your roster better. These are all reactionary moves to whether it be COVID or injury. And who knows? Friday night, you can see Anatoly Golishev, and it keeps on continuing as the Islanders know they'll be without Brock Nelson longer term, 2 to 4 weeks, and Ryan Pulock, 4 to 6 weeks.
Well, I'm in on the other side of the coin, Brendan. I'm in talking about having to, you know, you don't use your normal 20 guys, and Rangers thus far, very healthy. One guy out for the rest of the year, but the other is 17 forwards, all ready to go, and it makes a difference. I mean, it's a tough league when you don't have, you know, your lineup.
Islanders, of course, starting the season on a 13-game road trip while they waited for this beautiful building to be completed. They never really got into a rhythm on the road trip. It was not a great schedule in terms of building any sort of rhythm. And now, good luck trying to build a rhythm when you don't know who you're going to have available on that day.
Well, yeah, and you're half your lineup's from the American Hockey League, so that makes it even a bigger challenge. But I'll tell you one thing: they played very hard tonight. They've been on their toes. And they've made a couple of mistakes, and they've paid the price. And this Ranger team is full of confidence and moved the puck extremely well and taken advantage of the Islanders' inexperience at times.
He gives a Zibanejad with a shot through the slot. Bounced away from Parisi, but Barzal catches up to it. Matt Barzal hits the trailer. Salo, the shot, tip, save. Rebound cleaned up in front by the Rangers. Kreider chips it around Salo, picks it up on the other side. Kreider with a shot, and that one deflected away. Parisi down the boards to get it. Puck in his skates. Kaapo Kakko dealing with Parisi. Salo on the far side. Potta comes over, ties up with Lundqvist. That allows Salo to get out. Area pass for Parisi. Out of his reach, though, as Nemeth made sure it stayed in center ice. 8 minutes gone. Third period action. Islanders got within one. 20 seconds later, Rangers got it back. Barzal turned it over to Panarin. And it's Ryan Strome to Panarin. Knocked away by Ledoux. Palmieri turns it up ice. Barzal there to pick it up. Leaves it for Hickey. Hickey leans in with a shot. Never made it to the goal. Hickey stays with it, follows it up. Took his man down in Hunt. Loud Barzal. Worked over by Keandre Miller. Stumbling but stays on his feet. It pops to the slot. Palmieri knocked off his edges.
Trouba strong on his skates. Remember, Trouba got knocked out in that series with the Rangers and near the end of the season by Matt Martin, and they missed him.
Yeah, Matt Martin lined him up in the corner. As Hutt throws it to the front. Missed a good chunk of the remainder of the season as down to the ice goes Gauthier, courtesy of Grant Hutt. This pass broken up by Fox. Good look by the Norris Trophy winner as Andreoff was off to the races.
They gambled and won that gamble.
Lindgren all the way over. Jericho, New York's Adam Fox tried to get it to the slot. Came to Hedl. He whiffed on a pass. Hutton leaves it for Wallstrom. Wallstrom up ice, 1-on-3. Now looking for help. Spots Andreoff. Opens up. His pass deflected off a skate. Koivula with a chance. Pushed away wide. Now it's Salo. Tees one up with a blast. That's blocked by Hedl out to center.
And good job by Hedl to get in front. But puck retrieval by the Islanders creating some offensive opportunities. Look to get one in the next 5 minutes so they can get a little push going.
Lobbed it into the slot. Bouncing puck. Koivula couldn't grab it. Rooney worked in, bumped away by Salo. Ryan Reaves out to get it. This line has produced two of the three goals and the two even strength goals for the Rangers as Nevin's shot into the chest of Varlamov. First career two-goal game for Kevin Rooney, and the Rangers are up two. learning on the fly here tonight. Grant Hutton playing in his third NHL game. Paul Ledoux, his first in a couple of years.
Well, when you're a young defenseman and you have an opportunity, you try to keep your game simple. You try to keep the man in front of you, keep the puck to the outside. And then these young defensemen with very little experience have done a pretty good job with that. Hutton with a strong look there. And Salo, you know, get your head up, make sure you get your shot to the net. That one gets blocked, but again, you know, nothing's perfect out there, Brendan. It's quick. It's a learning experience, and as they go along, as I said, they'll get more and more confidence and get smarter with the puck, make better decisions, figure out how to get it past a guy like Hedl.
Salo with a block on the defensive end here that has the puck inside the Rangers zone. Palmieri, Pageau, and Beauvillier. Out for the shift for the Islanders, and it's J.G. Pageau protecting the puck. Works it near side. Mayfield thought about coming in. Beauvillier comes over. Puck on the stick of Chris Kreider. Quickly now for Kako.
Bo has not had a very good game. Just doesn't seem to be able to shake loose at all. And non-existent out there.
The Banajad for Kreider, and they score! Another turnover. A nice pass from Zibanejad. Kreider finishes. He's got two tonight.
Yeah, when you're hot boil, you know, you're just brimming with confidence. And Kreider, as soon as he gets the puck, no hesitation at all. Islanders go in the corner. There's Salo. Pageau's there. Turnover. Talk about it all the time, Brendan. You know, when you go at someone and you're around someone, don't let him beat you back to the net. And Kreider drives to the net. That's over two sticks. Zibanejad, I mean, you talk about talent and skill. Rangers have pretty much put this game away. Knew it was going to be hard for the Islanders. And now you can bemoan about the loss at the end of the day, and you're going to look back to the power play. That's what it's going to come down to. When you could have built yourself a lead, didn't happen. And Rangers have an awful lot of skill, and you make mistakes in your own zone with rookie defensemen, they're going to pay the price.
Islanders are 0-for-5 on the power play. Played a pretty solid first period and then took a penalty on the opening faceoff in the second. Rangers scored, and it's been hard to climb out of that hole.
Well, it opened the game up for the Rangers. I felt the Rangers knew they were in a hockey game, and they weren't as free skating. The Islanders did a nice job of tying them up. And then that goal seemed to really open them up a whole lot, give them some confidence to play the game.
Barzal had Nemeth stumbling. Barzal trying to take it to the net. Instead, turns, feeds it across for Aho. Had to juggle the pass, collect. Barzal with a shot. Shesterkin is there.
A good reaction by Shesterkin. I mean, again, the Islanders come right back again. Puck's bouncing, but Aho's coming in looking for an opportunity. Barzal pass didn't get it done, but then gives it back to Barzal. But Shesterkin's on his game too as he hits. As soon as that pass is on the slider, he moves towards the potential shooter of Barzal. All of these guys, I can assure you, are going to be so frustrated because nobody likes to lose, and now they're on an extended losing streak, and everything they're touching right now is certainly not going to go.
Keandre Miller lost it at center ice. Islanders can't pick it up. Gauthier flying in, trying to go wide. Hutton, a good defensive play. Gauthier's pass to Hedl. Hedl, and it's Hutton again to break it up. A couple of strong plays in his own end for Grant Hutton.
You got to put that in. You can't, you know, the game's 4-1. You can't do it on your own, and that's not going to make Barry very, very happy. You got to, you know, have a little bit of smarts. Don't worry about the score. You still got to play a solid game. Turnovers are the death to your hockey club.
Matt Martin can't get it deep as Fox's skates were in the way. And it's Aho. Finds center end. Couldn't dump it in as it hit Ryan Reeves and threw the whole thing offside.
Try and keep the puck on your forehand if you can. And Barry Trotz has to play the hand he's dealt, Brendan, and he's missing some aces and some kings. You know, that makes it difficult at this level.
Lou Lamoriello addressed the media tonight just before game time, 5 o'clock. And he was asked point blank about was there any talk of postponement and whether or not these games would be played. And he said no, and he really has no idea what the league's intentions are, and so his team continues to prepare to play. But they're missing seven guys on COVID protocol. There's been one team that has had games suspended this year because of an outbreak of COVID, and that's the Ottawa Senators. It took them 10 players and a coach on COVID protocol before the games were suspended. They had to play a game with 9 players missing on COVID protocol. So I guess the standard has been set. You got to get 10 players before they're going to call off a game. The problem with the Islanders situation is they've got 7 on COVID and 3 more with injury. They're missing 10 players.
Yeah, that's exactly right. They've only got basically 8 regulars playing. Their entire defense is depleted. And I just think at the NHL, at some point in time, you've got to look at the product and say, is this really the product we want playing in the National Hockey League? And clearly, when you're, as you mentioned, when you're down 10 players.
Lindgren is injured behind the play. Pageau through the hit. Fox puts him in a headlock. And now things are getting out of hand. Lindgren is hurt. Or at least thought he was hurt, and then goes and gets a stick. But Adam Fox just beelined it for Pageau. There was no penalty called on the hit, I don't believe, the initial hit by Pageau. I would imagine we'll see some penalties here, at least to Adam Fox.
Now he's throwing Pageau out of the game, and there was no initial call. See what that hit's all about, whether he's giving him a boarding penalty or whatever the case may be. Well, that's it. Now they heat up a little bit, and Pageau, will fight. So we'll see what happens next game with Pageau and Fox. We'll take another look at this as the two assistant captains talk to one another. I don't know if that's a. It looked like he just. That just refs right there. Well, he catches him in the head.
Get him in the head.
But the head hits the head.
And the referee right there, no arm up.
No.
No penalty on the play. That's the aftermath of it.
See if
Pageau's going to the dressing room.
Yeah, he's going to give him 5 minutes but I thought it was head on head. I mean, Pageau's smaller, so then.
I don't think he got a penalty here. They just called a 2-minute minor for roughing. No, he got him in the chest.
Well, his shoulder, his shoulder was there. I mean, he didn't hit him with his hands in the head area. And there's the referee. He sees the whole play, and there's no penalty there. There's nothing. Right there, number 20, 27, standing right there watching the whole play. And now Gallant's not happy, but there it is. Number 27 was right there watching the whole play.
That's Eric Furlan. I believe they announced a 2-minute minor for roughing for Adam Fox, and that's it. And that's exactly right. And Pageau comes back out onto the ice. I guess wanted to defuse the situation and brought Pageau to the bench because he wasn't penalized, and I think he misunderstood the actions of the officials and thought his night was over.
I thought it was a pretty clean hit, honestly. I mean, did he catch him a little in the head, but he's smaller, so hit him with his left shoulder. He didn't come up in any way, shape, or form.
As strange as it sounds, there is a legal check to the head, which is why the penalty is called an illegal check to the head.
Yes.
You can make contact with the head as long as it's not the main point of contact. And certainly was there a glancing blow to the head? Perhaps. But the main point of contact looked to be the chest, shoulder, collarbone area.
Yep, absolutely. That's trying to hit him with the left shoulder.
So the Islanders will get a power play. They're 6th of the game. Fox is in the box for roughing. We'll see if the Islanders can get one of them back. Second time in the last 3 games, the Islanders have had 6 power plays in it. Had 6 against the Calgary Flames. This one, look out, it came to Aho as he was just getting back to his feet. And Shesterkin able to make the stop.
Well, Shesterkin's been there when he's needed to be. He hasn't had to have a lot of great saves or any kind of saves in this game, but it had to be strong every once in a while, and that wasn't a trip.
Beauvillier coming over to get it. Aho was the option at the top. He tried to spin it back, and it's not going right tonight for Anthony Beauvillier. Winds up deflecting into the seats.
Now his game has not been very sharp. He's been slow to react, really. There's a trip going towards net. Aho, then Shesterkin with a good blocker save. he's been sharp and he's aggressive when he needs to be. He doesn't stay in his net. Gets out to the top of the crease when he has to.
Look out, Chris Kreider with a burst of speed, and Matt Barzal took it off his stick on the way by. Barzal over for Pageau. Pageau taken out of the play by Nemeth. Puck underneath him. Still underneath him. Now the whistles come. As Kreider's stick is...
Well, he's on top of Pageau, and puck's probably underneath Pageau. And he wasn't going to let him up. So, good call there.
Ryan Lindgren has gone to the dressing room for the New York Rangers following that hit by Pageau. Chris Kreider has two goals in this game. 23rd career multi-goal game. Second time he's done it to the Islanders.
Of course, Rooney has two. Good second effort there on that face-off by Goudreau.
Salo gloved it down, then played it with his stick so it could continue. And Wahlstrom has to double back out in the neutral zone to receive this one. 43 seconds left on the Islander power play. Long runway for Parisi. Lost it, got it back. Miller wraps the boards. It got through Koivula and goes down.
Earmarks have gone, what, 0 for 6, 0 for 7, Brendan?
If this holds up for 20 more seconds, they'll have gone 0 for 6.
Pretty tough to win a hockey game when you're not scoring a lot of goals and you go 0 for in your power play. And, I mean, what are they now over the last line? Been a little bit. Holy smokes. I mean, it's mind-boggling.
The month of November, they're 1 for 27. The kicker on that.
Yeah.
Is the shorthanded goals. As Hutton shot blocked down, save made, rebound there. But their power play's been outscored. They've given up more shorthanded goals, 3, than they've scored power play goals, 1.
And that's that's a mind-boggling stat, isn't it? When you think about it.
You want your power play and penalty kill combined to be the strength of your team. And right now, neither are working all that well for the Islanders as Hedl throws the brakes on the half wall. Islanders power play is over as Trouba pushed one towards the net. Matt Martin coming over, dealing with Miller. Flutterbuck there as well. Trouba had to get rid of it in a hurry with Cizikas coming after him. 3.5 to go, and Hedl the chip and change.
Yeah, exactly. And then the Rangers will be doing that for the rest of the game. Or at least should be. They've got enough goals to win.
Panarin back in the net. Ryan Reeves wreaking havoc in front of the goal. That one thrown in Reeves' direction. Matt Barzal has to move it. Hutton to Hickey.
Then has to move himself. Yeah. Reeves is coming at him.
Get off the tracks.
Yep.
There was a hit that knocked down Ponick, delivered by Goudreau as he kind of jumped into him. And Ledoux over for Hickey inside of the final 3 minutes. Shots are even, 21 apiece. Take that for what it's worth. As Rooney shovels it down the ice and Hickey will go get it.
Nothing.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Only matters on the scoreboard, that's it.
Tell you what, you know, the Islanders have had a few chances. Igor Shesterkin, after a relatively average season last year in his second NHL campaign, boy, he has been lights out to start this year, not just tonight, but overall. He's got a save percentage of .931 coming into this game, and it seems like every time the Rangers make a mistake, he's there.
Yeah, he's been good, and he's been a difference maker at times in games prior to this when he's played. And, you know, it takes everybody.
Lafreniere's coming after Pageau. Lafreniere swiped the skates out from underneath him and then came right after him. And the former number one overall pick just came and picked a fight with J.G. Pageau. He's been demoted in his role on this team down to fourth line at some point by Gerard Gallant. Apparently he's embraced that role.
Yeah. Well, they got him playing with Hedl and Gulchen most of the time.
Here's the question, though. you should hand out an instigator for what he just did.
Yep, absolutely.
An instigator in the last 5 minutes carries with it an automatic one-game suspension. So Lafreniere, I don't think he does that much in terms of fighting. I'm not even sure he knows that. But if they call an instigator right here, Lafreniere is going to get the shower for tonight and for Friday against Boston as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And see the replay here. Just see what happened. There's the...
Pulls his skates out first as he's skating by, and then as he's getting up, Lafreniere just comes right after him.
13 Rangers, 44 Islanders, both 5 minute team fighting.
They just give the 5 minute fighting majors.
How do you not call that instigation? How do you not give an instigator? And then they didn't get the 2 minute penalty for tripping either.
No.
That's awful. That's awful, refereeing. What are you watching? I mean, there's Lafreniere. Trips him. And then he goes right back at him. I mean, what is instigation then if that isn't it?
And this is the reason why they put that instigator rule in for the last 5 minutes, because they don't want games to get out of hand. I mean, this is a recipe for it.
Well, now you've got a different setup for the next game, Brendan. That's what happens now.
That's on Sunday at Madison Square Garden.
Yep. Oh, you got a whole different game set up, and Pageau's a feisty guy.
Clutterbuck moves it over for Cizikas. Cizikas, a muffled shot that is guided over the glass. Matt Martin. Cizikas and Clutterbuck. No surprise on the ice for that shift, but so is Ryan Reeves for the Rangers.
Matt Martin's not going to fight now. There's nothing to gain by fighting right now. You want to pick your spots when it means something.
No, but I would imagine those guys are out there as a deterrent.
Oh, sure.
Right?
Exactly. Yeah.
Matt Martin and Ryan Reeves aren't going to start something right now. They're out there to make sure nobody else does.
Nope. And the Cizikas line is still out there.
Here's Rooney. Think back, Pageau, in his NHL or in his Islanders debut was a game against the Rangers. And he actually got called for an instigation.
With Truba.
With Truba, yeah, that's right. Approaching the final minute here. Nemeth to the goal, blocked by Mayfield. Picked up room to skate for Otto Koivula. Andrioff, the lone goal scorer for the Islanders. This one at the side of the net, Clutterbuck there. Clutterbuck with a bump on Gauthier. Right at the line, Dryden Hunt moves it around Aho. We've got 40 seconds left as Gauthier will shoot it down the boards. Well, the Islanders forced to play this game under adverse conditions. Missing 10 players, really. 7 on COVID, 3 because of injury. 5 of their top 6 defensemen are out. And unfortunately, their first win here at UBS Arena will have to wait again, although gloves are off again. This was Dryden Hunt going after Wahlstrom.
And Andrioff was helping him out just to pull him off.
It's almost like if you started handing out misconducts a little bit earlier, this wouldn't have happened.
Well, they let the last one go, and not sure that anybody instigated that one.
Dryden Hunt decided to celebrate his birthday with a fight before he heads to the showers.
Well, let's just kind of see what goes on here, if there's anything major. He just pushed him and then slashed, and they slashed each other. It doesn't look like Wahlstrom ever gets his gloves off until he's down, but 5 and 5. Slashing or whatever, 7 and 7, whatever you want to do. And
good news for the Rangers, Ryan Lindgren has just returned to the Ranger bench. He's the one that got hit that started all of this.
Right.
We'll see what penalties are called from here.
They may want
another power play. This is going to be a Ranger power play, at least the way they just pointed where the faceoff's going to be. It's going to be a Ranger power play.
Andrioff's going to get 2 minutes for whatever.
2 minutes for slash. Rangers 2 minutes for roughing.
So they give Wahlstrom and only Wahlstrom a slash. They both get a rough.
Oh, they've lost control of this game.
And it's a Ranger power play.
Yeah, I mean, what's the score here? 13 seconds left.
Brydon Hunt and Oliver Wahlstrom have actually fought before.
Well, have they really, huh?
In Bridgeport and Springfield in the American Hockey League, April of 2019. So a late power play here for the Rangers, and I mean late, 3 seconds to go in the hockey game. They'll tee one up for Nemeth, a half-hearted shot towards the goal, and the Rangers win 4-1, and the Islanders' losing streak hits 7.
And it's, you know, it's not a huge surprise. The Rangers with a full squad, and not to make any excuses. I mean, the Islanders were in the hockey game. They had a really good first period. They were on their toes, and you talked about it early on, Brendan. They took a penalty right off the opening faceoff. Kreider was able to get the power play goal, and it changed the whole game. It just seemed to give the Rangers some energy, and that's all they needed. And the Islanders took a step back. And for what it's worth, there was a lot of good things out there. There was a lot of effort. We saw some good things from the young guys, the minor leaguers, if you will. And it's, you know, the team that won was the team was better, but the Islanders still hurt themselves with, again, no power play and some critical mistakes at critical times.
It was going to be a tough test for the Islanders with a full roster. They didn't have it. Igor Shesterkin, his 10th win of the season. The Rangers take this one from the Islanders at UBS Arena. 4-1 the final. We're back to wrap things up from Belmont Park next.